we've done it. We've published our initial version of our NerdDice gem to RubyGems. Here you can see it. It's not very interesting yet. It's only got one method, but it's there. It's got its signing key and all that stuff. Before we continue developing some actual code features here, we're going to take a brief interlude and do some housekeeping with our gem. So if you notice here, if you go to look at the NerdDice repo, we've got a couple issues that I've opened, one of which is that the changelog link in the gem spec is broken. So if I go to NerdDice here and I go to changelog, gets not found. So the other thing is that we're going to wind up, if we wind up making fixes like that to the 0.1.x version of our gem, we're going to want to have that have its own branch so that we can maintain multiple versions of our gem on different branches. This is largely academic right now. As you can see, total downloads is zero for this gem, so it's really not needed, but it's more of an educational type of thing. So we'll go and start doing this. So our got a working, clean working tree, and we only have the master branch. So we're going to do git checkout dash b. Stable there. Means that we're not going to be adding any new features to it. We'll be doing some bug fixes and stuff like that, but the actual feature versions of 0.1 are not going to get added to. So we've got our new branch. We're going to push it. The dash U that sets up remote tracking for it. We've got a new branch. It has the right now the branches are identical. They're how is that one commit ahead of master? I never pushed master. So let's push master. So now our branches should be even with each other. They are even. So the first thing we're going to do is go into our changelog here, change this to 12.7, because that's what it shows on RubyGems. We're going to now change our version on master to 0.2.0, because that'll be the next version that master will be targeting. And we're also going to want to follow the preferred RubyGem's security practice of putting our checksums in our repo. So we're going to do checksum, and we're going to just go into normal IRB. To require digest SHA-2. Our built gem path is going to be different, but well, at least SHA-512 for that. So now we should have a file in our checksum directory that has that 512 hash. We also, on our page here, there is a hash for the published version of the package. Somewhere there, SHA-256. Make sure that we're equaling. Equal. So we'll also add that. this is checksum 256 path. So we've got our checksums. They're both in the repo. And we've done this once, and I don't want to have to do this in IRB again. So we're going to copy it. I'm going to open up Sublime. Paste. And we've got these lines that have the results. These lines have our results. This is a result line. Control Shift L is one of my favorite things ever. Now we've got it. Project now in bin, we're going to get a new file called generate checksums. Executable. Interpolate here. All these, I made the mistake of making single quotes. And we're gonna exit out of here. now we're going to... make the file executable. Are all 775, it looks like. Matches. Six matches, 512 matches. So now whenever we release, we'll be able to do bin generate checksums and then our version, and we'll have it there. So we're going to of the olds. Alright, that's all well and good. So we want some of this to be backportable to version 0.1 and some of it to not be. So we're going to we're good on. So changelog, we'll port the update there. Jump file lock and version will leave the same. So we want to add also want to fix the gem spec. So that the changelog URI is correct. So we're going to go to our repo. You're on master. I'm going to click on changelog. And duplicate documentation URI. That means that we were likely missing one of the other kinds of URIs for the specification. Check that out. Metadata. Mailing list, we didn't have source code. We do have wiki, we do not have, I believe. And I was looking over on the repo with packages. Is it something about adding your GitHub URI to metadata? GitHub repo. Just add that in place of the I know a lot of these are pointing to the same URL. Good there. Alright, so we fix that. Fix the duplication there. I think we're good. Version, we want to keep the same. We're going to add gem spec. We'll commit. Got our commit message. And we will get that us. We are on master right now. So there, you can see here in summary that head version 01 stable, origin master, and master are all there. And then the tag and the the remote tracking and the actual remote are one commit behind. So let's make sure that our everything we want there. Here. Push. So now on GitHub we've got in our code got master. It's one commit behind master. We're going to go and I think that'll be good for now. It's not urgent enough to go and release a 0.1.1 to just to fix that gem spec issue. Wait a little bit longer to take care of that, but that's it for this recording. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.